Oh, we're pretty excited. I think Alex has done a terrific job this offseason. I think, you know, he's got the players, he's got the speed. I mean, it's going to be an entertaining team. We got power, we got speed, we got defense, we got pitching. You know, it's one of those ones where we're optimistic. Cautiously optimistic, as they say, you have to play the games, but we're optimistic.
Well, last year, some of the fans here were talking about, why didn't we get Darvish? Why didn't you get Fielder? This year, do you think it's going to be a little bit different?
I think so. I mean, I think, you know, from the point of view of the owners, they stepped up. I think that Alex stepped up equally as much when he put together the trade. He was relentless in pursuing it, was able to do it, and I think at the very end of the day, I think that you know, the fans are going to enjoy a good baseball season. Then when he made the second trade, you know, to get Dickey, you know, and sign Melky Cabrera, you know, all of it came together very, very quickly, but I think in a fashion that made a lot of sense. And I think the most important part about it is that it was done very smartly. I mean, I think Alex had a, you know, logistical point of way that he came about doing it. And as soon as he ended up making the big trade, he said, we still need one more pitcher. And then he went out and made the deal for Dickey. But that was not something that came quickly, because he'd spent 3 years building the farm system. And, you know, 3 years ago, we would not have been able to do that because we didn't have the talent to trade at that point in time. So now we were kind of in the reverse of the Roy Halladay situation, where there was enough good talent in the minor leagues that we were able to take that and trade it and get some players for now and hopefully for the next 3 or 4 years, because this is not just a one-year fix. I mean, it's something that we've always wanted to do, which was to be sustainable, and I think he's been able to pull that off.
Well, and last year, too, fans were hoping that maybe more money would be brought in, and that was the case.
It was never about money. I mean, money would have been there last year, too. I mean, that was not the issue. I mean, it was never about money. It was spending money smartly or spending money stupid. And this was spending money smart. And, you know, when you can make a trade and you can get the players you got back in the trade, now all of a sudden a guy like R.A. Dickey says, you know, Toronto's a place I might want to go. And so I suspect if the R.A. Dickey trade had come up first, he may have said, maybe I don't want to go there. So you can always go and get players. You can always spend money. But you can always put yourself in a position where you've got these contracts that go for a long time, and you know, they're not the A players. I mean, he came up with some A players, starters, position players. It's pretty exciting.
And do you think that's going to be the shift now? It seems Toronto fans are always a little self-conscious that maybe players don't want to come to Toronto, but do you see that shift happening now?
Oh, sure. I mean, I never ever worried about it before. I mean, I think always players would want to come to Toronto, but the mobility of the best players are always to the place where they got the best chance of winning. And, you know, I think they see this as a chance of winning. Alex, when he went down to see Dickey, you know, obviously R.A. said, you know, I'm prepared to entertain a long-term deal. And so that's what he did. And so from the perspective of being able to attract players, it's never been about the city. The city's a selling point. The stadium is a selling point, notwithstanding the fact that, you know, we may be critical of it and we may malign it. The reality of the situation, players like playing in the stadium because it's got a roof and they play whenever they're supposed to play. And so I think from the perspective of the city, I mean, I've never worried about it. They'll want to come here if we've got a chance to win. It's no different than any other city.
We were speaking with Alex about it just before, but with spring training and the World Baseball Classic, is there a concern that about a fifth of the starting lineup's going to be there, or are you not worried?
Well, I mean, it's not the ideal year, but we do believe, I mean, we're an international team. I mean, you know, so it's tough for us to be against international baseball. I mean, so I think you have to look at it from the perspective it's a good thing for the game of baseball. The fact that this is a year when we have so many new players, you would like them all to go to spring training, stay together in spring training, and you'll get to know one another. So that would be the ideal situation. But it's not, you know, and that's the cards we've been dealt, so we'll deal with them.
Talked about cautious optimism, and I think there's more excitement around here than in a long time, i.e. let's go Blue Jays chance at Leaf games. How do you temper that and kind of say, everyone, okay, calm down a bit, it's going to be a long season?
Well, I don't know if you want to temper it, but, you know, I don't think you want to add fuel to the fire either. I mean, you know, from the point of view of what Alex has done, I mean, he's put together a team that I think is recognized by everybody as a team that should contend. So, I mean, I don't think we want to downplay that, but I don't think at the same time, no matter if you're the 27 Yankees, there's no guarantee you're going to win the World Series because you've got to get to the playoffs, but you want to give yourself a chance. And I think he's done as good a job as anybody could do in transforming a team. I mean, this is a transformative offseason. I mean, I don't think we went into it, we could have hoped to do this, but I don't think we could have anticipated doing this. On the other hand, you know, I don't think that you can get back and say, you know, like, this is going to win the World Series. But, you know, if you get to the playoffs, anything can happen.
Can you compare this in the way of excitement towards the season, going back to the early 90s and the World Championship years?
Well, that was a different time because we were building at that point in time. You know, we'd been good in 85, we'd been good in 87, we'd been good in 89. You know, we had gone to the playoffs in 91 and then we won in 92 and 93. We were bad in 2012. And, you know, all of a sudden in 2013, you know, we're supposed to be great. I mean, so, I mean, it just happened kind of over a period of 2 months. So, I mean, it's a little bit different. That was gradual. There was a lot of frustration back then. You know, we were always close, but we were never able to grab that ring. So I think this year, I don't know what people expected, but quite clearly, I didn't expect this. I'm not so sure Alex expected this. But when the opportunity presented itself, you know, he was he pursued it. He pursued it successfully. Ownership stood their ground and gave us the resources to do it. So it was all plus plus.
There appears to be serious talk now about putting grass in the Rogers Center. How soon do you think it'll be? And two, is there any talk about a dirt infield? And have the players voice their opinions on that?
Well, I think all the players like to play on grass. I mean, you know, when you play 162 games, I think it's tougher to play on turf. And there's only two turf fields right now. You know, baseball's going to grass. There have been a lot more turf fields before. Football seems to be going to turf. You know, there's more turf fields than there are grass fields. But I think at the very end of the day, you know, we will have grass here at some point in time. That would mean a dirt infield. I mean, we would do it not halfway. We would do it all the way. It doesn't make any sense for us just to put the cutouts in. If we're going to do it, we would set it up so that we played the full season on grass and see what happened, which would require some engineering. But, you know, it can be done.